Yeah, Venus system. Now, the next 5 minutes is going to be very, very interesting, very, very critical. There are two things in this slide. Slide is very complicated, but I will lead you step by step. There are two things. One is normal fetal circulation. Two, changes that occur at birth. You see, that means there is some drastic change that takes place at birth. You know, what you know symbolically as the baby crying at birth is actually, it means that it is taking a deep gasp, taking a deep breath of air for the first time in its life. As it takes the air, okay, we can call it its born and all the auspicious things and distribution of sweets by mommy and daddy, all that is different. But what is happening is there is a drastic change in the fetal circulation. The fetal circulation transits into the adult pattern of circulation. To understand that transit, you need to understand how the fetal circulation is going on. The fundamental point to remember in fetal circulation is the lung is not the source of oxygen. You see, the lung is not the source of oxygen. And if you extend this corollary, you will also realize the intestines of the fetus is not the source of nourishment, because both the oxygen and the nourishment are coming collectively from the same source, placenta. Now the placenta is therefore the lung as well as the intestines as far as the fetus is concerned. Got my point? The circulatory system is also proportionately tuned to receive this oxygen and nourishment. So what happens is, watch carefully what I'm talking. Now, lower down somewhere here is the placenta, okay? From the placenta, food is coming, oxygen is coming, it goes into the liver, through the liver, and then into the vena cava system. Okay, there's hardly any work there because the liver is not fully functional. It's not going to process the food. It is already processed in the mom, in the mother, and fully processed fast food is reaching the fetus. From here, watch carefully what I'm talking. It goes through the IVC, goes into the right atrium. This is fetal circulation. From the right atrium, while it can go into the right ventricle, because of that interatrial septal gap, it goes into the right left atrium. From the left atrium into the aorta, I repeat, this is the left atrium into the aorta, and from there into the systemic circulation into the body. Did you notice that although some blood can go into the lung, the pulmonary circulation is generally bypassed because of this shunt, and the blood directly goes to the systemic. The reason is it is already oxygenated by the placenta. There is no need for going through the lung at this stage. Then from the aorta, it goes to the human body on the capillary bed. Then it comes back to the placenta here, comes back to the placenta. Okay, so here is a system where food and oxygen come from the placenta, go into the liver. Liver simply pushes it into the inferior vena cava through the hepatic veins, from there into the heart, and from the heart into the systemic circulation and back to the placenta. Now, how dramatic is this birth and what is its consequence on the cardiorespiratory system is what I'm going to talk to you. Now, at birth, what happens? The placenta is disconnected. When you cut the umbilical cord, there is no oxygen, there is no food available. Now, the human body now in transit between fetal to the post uterine life has no oxygen, has no food. At that point, there are functional mechanisms that trigger the first breath. That trigger the first breath. Coinciding with the first breath, the entire vascular tree of the pulmonary circulation opens up. Together with that, the lung, lung spaces open up, and that huge rush of oxygen on the first breath mixes with the blood in the vascular bed, and for the first time in that great thing called the first breath, oxygenated blood is being issued by another organ, which is not the placenta. So oxygen is taken care of. Once that blood is now reaching the capillary bed, there is no reason why the blood should bypass the liver. It is forced to the liver. And what I showed you as patent of the, so what I showed you as the ductus arteriosus connecting the left branch of the pulmonary artery with the aorta regresses. As a result of this regression, the systemic circulation is set into motion or set into full stream. It was running even otherwise. It is made exclusive now. You see, it's made exclusive now. As a result, for the first time, the pulmonary circulation is set into motion, and another independent aortic based or systemic circulation is also set into motion. This is a critical change. This is a critical change. Even if a few minutes goes when without that baby taking the first breath and crying, you know something is serious. You know something is serious, and that's what you will see in YouTube videos where the doctors will intervene and do something to make the baby cry. And you know, many things can happen where there is a delay, but this delay may be very dangerous, because for that many minutes the baby is devoid of oxygen. Okay, and if not resuscitated in time, the baby is going to die. So based on what I'm trying to say, feel happy that every normal birth is the greatest miracle of life. Would you agree or not agree because of this?
Yes.
Yes. When therefore, when the baby is born, daddy and relatives are waiting outside, and the nurse comes out and says, normal baby, you know, girl baby, boy baby, the gender doesn't matter. The moment that nurse utters the word normal baby, okay, you will have to shout with joy and dance with joy. You know, you will see a lot of emotional scenes, particularly in movies and all that. But in real life also, it is true. So what I want you to do as students and future ambassadors of this kind of knowledge in your careers, if you had, you know, if there was a normal birth at home and you used to dance with joy, hereafter dance with joy 1,000 times more, because it's worth it. God has given you the greatest gift that is ever possible with zero problems. You see, you know how much trauma or how much of stress that child, that baby has gone through in the process of birth. Okay, so if somebody says, you know, you're doing an extravagant this thing, birthday, and yeah, it's worth it, because life is precious, and that little life is your child. Okay, and it's worth the celebration. Right, next we'll move on to the next stage. Sometimes